remember you. What arrogance to think that you can defeat a prophet. That you can fight a god. Look around you. Say your last prayers to your deceased deity. And prepare to face the eternal fire. The black sun will scorch the flesh from your bones and burn you to ashes. Go forth, my children, and devour this blasphemy in the name of Aten! For the sun! For the black sun!
Oh. You rejected our kind and generous offer when you were here last. What makes you think we will allow you to enter our dreams, to speak with us, to gaze upon us? We are tired of you, maggot. Leave, or we will wipe you from existence. You are nothing but a parasite. You are insignificant. If I thought you were worth another thought, I would destroy you. But you are unworthy of our attentions.
Nicholas? What I do? Your leader, Imam.
You pathetic, fragile thing. Undone by mere molecules, by things so small they cannot even be seen. You are a ridiculous creation, weak and brief.
Where is Nicholas Belmont? Is he still here?
You think you can trust those around you? Those you love and hold dear? You believe friendship to be anything but an illusion? They are all ours. Their words and their actions. We whisper in their dreams and we make them do our bidding.
Thank you.
A mere thought from us, and you would vanish from this place and enter another. You would see sights that would destroy you inside and out. We would leave only enough of you to mourn the loss of your soul. We are nothing if not forgiving. Choose correctly, and we may allow you to make amends.
I'm close.
The world can still be yours if you simply accept our path. This kindness will not be extended to all who defy us. Kneel before us. Show us that you are with us, not against us. You ingrate. We gracefully extend a hand in forgiveness, and you spit into it. You pathetic little thing. You unworthy animal. You will infect our dreams no more. And the riches of the new world will never be yours.